love your neighbour, love your enemy even. You know? And yet you're laughing about child abuse cover-up. You don't care about, you know, the organisation forking out $4,000 a day to protect pedophiles against a court order. I thought the idea was to follow the law. It doesn't go against God's law. So why is the organisation paying out money to go against a legitimate court order?
I'll ask them.
But that's just it. I'd like to know your opinion on it.
I've told you my opinion.
You don't care?
I don't care.
You don't care that the organisation is protecting the nation?
So you're going to go over this again now, are you?
Yeah, yeah, I'm just going to keep on going.
Do you want to sit down for a bit?
No, I'm fine here. You know, you being facetious, it's even better.
You take your time, you know.
I've got all the time in the world.
You
so
sit down.
You know.
You write me to get your coffee.
Ah, you're being facetious. You do realise how this actually makes you look. It only proves the point that people in the organisation really don't care about the child abuse. You're laughing about it. Every time I say child abuse, you laugh about it. So
no, I laugh about the way you're carrying on, that's all.
I'm carrying on, so I'm like not. Having an issue
like
with child abuse?
You're like a clown. A clown that has little parts to play.
Oh, right. And what would that part be?
Pray tell. That's good,
yeah. Yeah, but what part would that be?
Part of stupidity.
But because I'm confronting people in an organisation who defend the organisation, basically, over their child abuse.
Oh, mate, you are so funny.
Yeah. You do realise this is a, you know, an old standard tactic that has been done plenty of times before. I've even done it myself, actually. The mocking of someone to try and diminish what they're saying. And to diminish your own frustration, too.
Have you ever been to a psychiatrist?
So now you're saying that someone who has an issue with the cover-up of child abuse...
Have you ever been to a psychiatrist?
...has got a mental illness?
Yeah, I think you've got a mental illness.
Because I've got an issue with an organisation covering up child abuse.
Do you pay rent somewhere, or do you support the society, or do you bludge off it?
Bludge off society?
Do you bludge off it, do you?
Okay. Don't try and turn this on me, okay?
Do you bludge off the society?
Don't try and turn this on me, okay?
No.
Yes. You're not turning it on me because you're now getting upset again because I'm not letting up on the fact.
I want to know if you bludge on the society or do you pay your way? Are you a bludger or do you pay your way?
And I'm not going to tell you anything about myself.
No, because you're a bludger.
Oh, right, I'm a bludger.
You go to the Dole and get your money. You live in your car.
I'm actually on a disability pension.
I know you've got a disability pension.
Disability pension.
Yeah, I know. That sticks out a mile, that you've got a disability pension.
So you make it funny someone with a disability.
You've got a mental disability pension.
So you're making fun of someone with a disability, are you? Okay.
No, I feel sorry for you, mate.
Oh, no, actually, you just made fun of me because you're laughing at me.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I laugh at you, yeah.
Yeah, so you're basically laughing at someone who's got a disability.
Yep.
You're not the brightest, are you?
Neither are you.
Well, see, you're supposed to be representing the organisation here.
No.
No?
No, we're just talking now.
No, you're representing the organisation
and you're
laughing at me.
No, I'm asking you if you...
What are you in public for? What are you here for?
I'm here to listen to jokes like you.
Oh, so what's this here for then?
I'm just asking you, do you bludge on the society or do you pay your way?
I mean, I thought Christians were supposed to be humble,
but you are so
egotistical.
You won't answer that, will you, because you're a bludger.
Because it's actually none of your business.
You're a bludger.
I mean, yes.
You're a bludger.
What business is
yours? You're a bludger,
mate. So you're calling someone who's confronting you?
You're a bludger.
I'm a bludger.
Yeah, you're a bludger.
Because of...
This man's a bludger.
You do realise how you look? You do realise how you look?
This guy's a bludger. He bludges on society.
Yeah, because I'm confronting you about the child abuse in the organisation and you don't care.
Man bludges on society.
and you don't care about the child abuse.
You bludgeon on society.
Yeah. You do realise how this looks?
Yeah.
You're making the organisation look bad because you are being, well, extremely unchristian. And please keep your space, okay? You're invading personal space.
No.
Oh, I see what you're going to do. You're going to try and intimidate me. Okay, this is even better. Are you going to cough in my face too? Okay.
Sorry about that.
So, you're not respecting a person's personal space. I've kept here, I've kept a good distance away, but you're not, you know, you just want to keep on getting in closer and closer when I've asked you to back off. Okay. Yeah, that'd be standard bully tactic. Wouldn't be surprised if you're like an elder or ministerial servant or something like that. Because that's what they do so well. But yeah, I mean, I can do this all day, so, you know, it's all good. I've got 100 gigs worth of stuff
good,
here.
Have a good
day, have a good day. I'm having an awesome day. I was actually hoping for Marty or Mark, actually, eventually. Because Marty was the one who motivated me to do this when he decided to go with gangbusters. And Mark, he's the one who told me to look up the Royal Commission to get my facts. And I discovered so much more stuff. So, you know, I used to defend the witnesses constantly. Used to defend. And then I, you know, $2 million forked out. $2 million to protect the names of pedophiles. Oh, no, this has been done before too. It was done the other day pretty much, so I just spoke for, you know, a good 45 minutes or so. Asking the same questions. All the information out there, but because, you know, you're not allowed to look at things because they're apostate, you know, it's pretty bad when you're not allowed to see things, because if you do, you can get in the trouble, you can get the boot, you can get, yeah, disfellowshipped, shunned. What's that word you use when you are told off? Can't remember the name of it now. But yeah, just have to look up the Australian Royal Commission 2015. Report came out in November, actually. And there's an update. How it said that Jehovah's Witnesses were the worst of the lot. The only ones who have consistency to deny what's happening, to stick into archaic rules which suit them but tend to ignore other scriptural things, like following the laws of the land when, you know, it's not God's law, because it doesn't go against God's law to hand over a database of 24,000 pedophiles, you know, to the authorities. No, because pedophilia... Oh, wait a minute. I forgot. Sorry. Apparently, pedophilia is a sin, not a crime with the witnesses. You know, things like theft and murder and that. They're crimes. But sexually abusing a child, physically abusing a child, which also happened in one of the cases at the Royal Commission that was reported. No, that apparently is okay. You know, being told to respect your abuser, being told to... No, only because, you know, of his family. No, it doesn't matter the fact that, you know, he had sexually abused the sister and felt his stepdaughter's tit or anything. Nah, it's because, you know, he admitted it, but there was only one witness that, you know, he was allowed to stay around. I think he was actually disfellowshipped for, immoral conduct. He was having an affair. He wasn't kicked out for sexually abusing a child, but for screwing around with another woman. And they weren't even told. Oh, there's so much information out I can say here. You know, the number of the millions paid out in court and out of court settlements with people who've taken, well, abuse victims, taken the organisation to the court.